Lunch break. We were having some technical issues with the connection, as always. Welcome to another episode of Lunch Break. And I know you already see my apron on. Basically, we already started this and the connection went down. So, here we go again. We're making enchilada roll-ups today on Lunch Break with your host, me, Christian Knight. So, let's just get to it. Because we're bringing you the foods that you can make during your lunch break. All right, I'm going to sit you down so you can see the action. And hopefully I don't press any buttons by mistake again. All right, good. You see this Instagram. Okay, we're back on Facebook. And we're live. Good. So, as I was saying in the beginning, in order to make enchiladas, you need four. You need four key ingredients. And that's, of course, your ground meat, the flour tortilla, or any actual soft flour tortilla that you can come up with, because they do have different variations. Like they have whole wheat, they have some green one, there's a vegan thing, is I can't remember all of them, but look them up later. I know each one of you know what you eat. So then you're gonna need also the salsa for it, and you're gonna need the cheese. Those are the four main ingredients you need to make it chocolate. So, without further ado, in case we get lost again, I think the live is still on. Good. Okay, good. Hey, Didi, welcome back. Let's get to it. So, first thing we gotta do is, of course, is wash our hands. Wash our hands, people. Oh, wash your hands. Welcome to Lunch Break. We're making enchiladas, by the way. I'm talking to the people in this room. All right. Hands are nice and clean. Good drop. So, first thing we're gonna do is take our meat, put it into a nice little bowl, which has been washed already. Because I just dropped. Not before, but before, when I made preparations. So, I'm just gonna move you towards the action, peoples. There we go. We're gonna take our meat and just plop it in there. Okay. And the same way we season our ground beef for any of the shows that we do, for burgers, for meatballs and all that, is basically just this. So we've prepared a nice little variety of mixtures. So you're gonna need black pepper. 1 tablespoon of black pepper. There's black pepper. Throw it in there. 1 tablespoon of garlic powder. 1 tablespoon of onion powder. And 1 tablespoon of parsley flakes. That's it, right? That's done over there. We'll put this back. You're also gonna need an egg. So just take that guy. Say hello to my little friend, and just dump that in there. There we go. Ain't that nice? He made your friend. All right. Yep. Now let's take a nice fork so we can mix all this into. There we go. The next thing I need to get is a spatula for this place. So we can use a spatula to mix this thoroughly. Even though we can mix this with a spoon or a fork, which you are provided with at work. And just keep mixing this until all the ground beef has taken in. I might switch to a spoon just to get a little more control. Then we switch to a spoon. There we go. So in this way, mix them all together. And of course, for those who have been watching, who knows the one last ingredient you need to put into this. So in this way, we can start the process of what we're going to be doing for today. Anybody? Nobody? Ah. Breadcrumbs. So, what you want to do is add 1 cup. This is 1 cup, by the way. Of breadcrumbs. There we go. And mix that into the meat that you're using for this enchilada. There we go. Yeah, mix it real nice. Mix that, blend that right in. Look at that. Now all those things you put in the meat have been placed all together. Mmm. Next one, right? Oh, put it right there. So we're gonna take our cutting board, because we're gonna use this to make the roll-ups. So technically, what you would do is that you would take this meat and put it on a skillet and cook all the meat and make it into chopped meat. We are going to be doing a variation of that, where we're going to take the meat and make it into a ball and then roll it into almost like a hot dog looking sausage, so we can roll it up with our flour tortilla. Okay. So, let's get cracking. Make sure to wash your hands thoroughly before we touch the meat. And then we're gonna need a plate so we can put these guys in. Okay? So I'm gonna just set that there. And then, what you want to do is take a decent amount, I should say, not enough, of meat, which is cold, by the way, and make it into a nice little ball, right? And then, as you're making it into a nice little ball, we're gonna take this and roll it. That's right, roll it back and forth. See how it's turning into a nice little sausage-like patty? Yeah, mmm. Who knew you could do this, right? There you go, look, look, look. It's looking like a hot dog, people. Like a hot dog. Bam, take that.
Set it aside,
boom. Then take the next one. Do the same thing all over again. Don't forget to take a nice decent size, palm size meat. Roll it into a nice little ball. It's like a meatball per se that you're doing. And then just take it. And then you just roll it back and forth. Roll it back and forth, people. Roll it back and forth. See? Roll it back and forth and just flatten it along the way. Look at that. Mmm. There you go. Right, take it.
Set it aside. Might need another plate after this.
That's two right there. Ready to go. Nail. Alright. And then just continue doing this for a little bit. Ooh, look at that. I moved the camera by mistake. See? All you gotta do is make it into a nice little meatball looking thing. And then slap it right there. Do it one more time circular. And then just flatten it down as you go. As you can see, as you flatten it, it already converts itself into the nice looking hot dog roll up. Alright. Okay. And then I'm going to do two more. So this is where we get the party started. Little meatball.
Who's with us on the live?
Hey Jolie, what up? What up, Patricia? Hello, Bobby. Sergeant Williams, how you doing? Welcome to lives. I can't tell on this side who's on the live. I gotta look at the computer. There's still nobody on Instagram, but it's still good because you know they can watch this later from the comfort of their own home. Well, you probably guys are doing that right now. I am making enchilada roll-ups. So, basically because we're doing this at work at lunch.
For your break.
It's a different variety style that we have to do for this. Alright. Four. We'll do two more. So, thank you. I hope it is yummy because I've never done it yet. This is my first time. Like I said, anything we do here at lunch break is our first time ever. Literally. So, there we go. Then flatten it out as you go. I'm just trying to speed this up. So this way we can start the actual process of what we need to do for our enchiladas. There we go. Alright. And then one more. Oops, I keep moving you guys. One more so we can start. And then we'll do the rest of them offline. So just continue rolling this up. And by the way, that's D who just passed by. I'm alive. Oop. I'm not even paying attention to what I'm doing. Look at that. All right. So, yeah. I'm trying to speed up. That's why I'm trying to do so quick. All right. And mind you, these don't have to be perfect. There's no such thing. Listen, if you're making food for yourself, it's fine. You're making food for more than one, you could do this a lot different. This is basically one method of doing it for lunch break. Right there. All right, so now, let's wash our hands. Now, let's do one thing. Let's turn on our grill. So this way our grill will be ready for when we put our enchiladas on there. All right. What I'm going to do for now, so I'm going to place this right here. So I can use this side, because that was the meat side. This is the vegetable side. I have it all distinguished. And get our flour tortillas. Alright. Here's our first one. Oh my god, it's the first one. Now, we're gonna take our ground beef We're gonna put this in the middle, okay? And as we're doing that, we're gonna get ready our sauce and cheese that we're gonna add into it, okay? I'm gonna put this to the side. We don't need that for now. All right, and I'll just move this way so you can still see the action. And I get another spoon. Ah, perfection. There we go. And mind you, just make sure you shake or stir the salsa when you first open it. All right. Now, we're gonna take our meat, all right? And what we're going to do, so I'm gonna use a fork to place the meat in the middle. There you go. Spread some love of the salsa. And then spread some cheese. There you go. Alright. And that's what you gotta do. So you're gonna take this and literally fold it over. Right? Make sure you go deep enough. And ta-da! First one's already set, literally. So, what we're gonna do, because this is actually a little bit open, so we're gonna do it a little bit like a burrito style. So we're gonna close it there, and then just seal it up. There we go. Now we have our burrito style enchilada. I keep saying empanada. Enchilada, right there. We can plate, so we can put it on. There you go. All right, so we're gonna prepare our second one so we can put both of them on there to cook. So again, all you gotta do is grab your flour tortilla. See? All you gotta do is that. Stick in your hot dog looking ground beef or turkey or chicken, whatever it is that you're putting in this, because you can put whatever you want. Spread it with some love of the sauce onto it. There you go. Put this over here. And then spread some love with some cheese. Bam. And as we did before, roll it up, treat it as if you would a burrito, because this flour tortilla is pretty big. And then roll it up, and you're set. So now, seeing this is also to go too, we're gonna stick this guy right there. Right, we're gonna stick that guy right there. And what we're gonna do to add a little spiciness is throw some Worcestershire sauce into it. Ooh, hold on. Forgot to put in our little grease catcher. There you go. And then, let's close it up. Make sure. And then we'll push this way while we let that cook. Now, let's make sure we set our timers to at least 6 minutes. There we go. And that's basically it. That's all you gotta do, folks. What did I do with the hot plate warmers? No, hot pot holders. That's what it's called. And that's it. That's all you gotta do, peoples. You saw Shadow just came across the screen. And that's all you gotta do for the enchiladas, roll-ups, or burritos, however you wanna call it. Because, you know, that's how what we did. That's it. That's basically it. So, while those are cooking, right, let's do the rest of them. So, once again, like I said, the most easiest recipe you can ever do No, literally, no hard work in this. Flour tortilla. Bam. Meat in the middle. Bam. Spread salsa. Literally. Spread salsa. And then spread cheese. And that's all you gotta do. Now, some folks like it cheesy, some folks don't. It really depends on you. Like I said, when you're making this, you make it according to... you make it according to however way you like it. Because, like I said, you are the one making this for yourself, and you're the one eating it. Alright. And as we did before, all you gotta do is meet it with the other side. Flip it over. Flip it over. Continue to roll it, and bam, you made your burrito style enchilada. Alright, put that there. And then we do a continuation of the rest of them. And along the way, like I said, see me, I'm doing more than one. If you provide pressure on this, I like providing pressure on this as it cooks, just to cook everything thoroughly, because that's why we give it amount of time that we do. You can also take this out of the grill, pour some more sauce on top of it, put some more cheese, and then put it in the microwave, and you do a double dip. Double dip, peoples. Who's watching here? Oh, hey, God. Hey, Nancy. I'll say it's goddesses. What's up? All right. So, let's continue with this. Right there. Ow. I said that so. I forgot that thing was there. But you guys should see it. Well, I'll show you in another 30 more minutes. Because that's when that will be ready. There we go. Alright. Some salsa. And some cheese. And that's all you gotta do, is just repeat the process of that. Have a good weekend! Enjoy! People came shy. Alright, so meet the other one, fold one side, fold the other side, and then continue rolling it up, and you'll get your burrito style enchilada. I know I keep saying it, right? Alright. Then we got some more. There we go. Put that there. Grab the meat. Place it there. Grab the salsa. Put it there. And then grab the cheese. And that was Paige, by the way. On the live. Tuesday. Enjoy, have fun, man.
Yeah, you gotta switch it up and do a breakfast break.
Yes, we're gonna come do that, because I made, as a test, I made home fries with scrambled eggs. From potatoes. Straight.
We're about to translate to people I have.
But we will cover that.
Yeah.
Enjoy, brother, man. Enjoy your weekend. Because whatever happens on live, happens on live. Even in post edit. There we go. Put some cheese. Mmm, I wish you guys were able to smell this. Because the bomb is going off. Right? Meat, meat. Fold, fold. And then roll. And bam. Alright, and the last one. Take the meat, put it in the middle. Put the sauce. There you go. And put some cheese. Let the cheese come out of this thing. gotta be an easier way to get the cheese out of this. Maybe we get regular cheese and get a grater? Possibly, right? Alright, the alarm has gone off. So let's just finish this one up. Hold it. Hold it. And roll it. Alright. So put that there. Now we'll set this aside for now. And get a plate. And get our trusty handy tongs. Alright, there we go. Now who's ready to see this? Actually, this shows you what this looks like, right? Everybody at Instagram world, I will turn you that way. But look at this. Oh my god, look at that. That is insane. Alright, so let me put you guys back over here. So you guys can see the action. Let's grab this sucker. Grab this sucker. Ooh. Sorry about that. Put that right here. Alright. So now I'm gonna set this to the side. Alright. While we clean the grill. This is all the cheese, peoples. There we go. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. There we go. So now, once we do that, all we gotta do is set our next victims. There we go. Place that there. Place that there. Alright. And then of course, as we did before, Worcestershire sauce. Just to give it a nice little steak one sauce taste right there. And that's it. That's basically all you gotta do, peoples. Who's the James, what up, man? Welcome to the live. I had to look that way to see who's live. Like I said, I can't see who's live from the actual thing on this side. So, what up, man? So, we do have already 2 enchilada burritos to literally taste test. So from our audience over there, Omar's coming. Listen, Omar's been waiting since lunchtime to eat food. So there you go. Careful, man, it is extremely hot.
Yeah.
You want a knife or a fork or something?
Most
likely, yeah. Right. Cause I know those things are huge, so. I didn't expect them to be huge, but hey, that's what happens here on lunch break. It's go big or go home type of thing, right? Something like that. All right, so we set this one in. Let's remember always, set your timer. 6 minutes. And then that's it. See how easy that was? It took maybe, like I said, remember, I did a lot. So you guys can do this in a lot faster time than it's taking me to do the lot. Because I'm talking and explaining at the same time. Okay, but you can easily do this in probably 10 minutes, estimately, roughly 10 minutes. You can just smell that gloriousness. That's crazy smell right there. I think that's it. That's what we gotta do is just cook and put on. We got 2 more that we're setting in there. We might separate these because they're really huge. They're really huge. They're like burrito size huge. Hey, Didi! I don't know if anybody's going to eat a lot of these, or at least 2. So I'm going to separate them. Because I have more. See, look, I have more, and I have more over there that I got to make. So, we're not going hungry today. So, how is it, Omar? Awesome. So, I'm looking for where you went, okay. Oh man. Q, I should change the title from roll ups to burritos. But that's basically it. So it's basically ground meat that we seasoned with garlic powder, black pepper, onion powder, parsley flakes. We added one egg, and we also added breadcrumbs. And all that was one, well, except for the breadcrumbs, it was all one tablespoon. The breadcrumbs was one cup. You mix that all together into your nice little mixture of meat over there, or ground beef, or whatever one you want to call it, so someone doesn't think it's non-sexual or orientation over there. Then you take the ground beef, roll it into a ball, then you, as you roll it downwards to make it into a hot dog shape or a sausage shape, put that in the middle of the flour tortilla, put some sauce. Like I said, you can get any type of sauce you want, like, oh, you can even get enchilada sauce if you want. Put the sauce in there, spread it with some cheese, whatever cheese you like, or if you can't have cheese, then don't add the cheese. Please don't end up in the hospital because you added cheese and I told you so. That is not my responsibility, okay? I am not paying those hospital bills. So, then roll it up, put it, max it together, and put it on the grill. You can also put it on the skillet, which you're gonna have to do each side as you're cooking it. But this grill here has two sides that cooks, so we only need to make it in a certain amount of time for both sides, one time. Oh, and there's only 2 more minutes left for this one. And how's everybody over there? In Instagram. So, yes. So that's all you need to do. Basically, it's that simple. So, we're going to move this to the bottom here. Move these onions this way. We don't need these anymore. Only so we can make space for our burrito styles. It's about to be taken out. Alright. There we go. Oh, you hear the sizzle? Do you hear the sizzle? Yeah, I love that sizzle. But that's basically it, peoples. What other things can you make besides this enchilada? Can you place with it? Like, I was gonna put it in a bed of rice, but I think itself, the way it was, I think would have been enough for everybody. Normally you would make these enchiladas with the small flour tortillas, which probably should have been the better bet to get. Because I think those are the same ones that they use for, like, to make tacos or mini tacos. You can make these into breakfast burritos too. You know, all you gotta do is scramble the eggs, the sausage, mix them together, put it in that little bad boy of a flour tortilla, roll it up, and then put it back on the grill, and you have yourself a breakfast burrito right there. You don't have to go into the store and buy that and get it from someone who needs to cook it. You need to go home and cook it yourself. Literally, no one can say they can't cook, because anyone can make toast. And that's cooking right there, okay? So don't ever say you can't cook. Even if you can make toast, you can cook. Ooh, this is about to sound off in like 40 seconds. Who's ready to see this? Do you people on Instagram and Facebook, do you want to see this? Uh-oh, smells good. And it's dangerous. Where's our tongues? Let's get our nice little dandy tongues over here. And in about 20 seconds, the next batch will be ready, which I'm gonna separate to 2 different plates, only because it's big. It's a big, massive burrito. Even I don't think I could be able to eat 2. I think I could just eat 1. With 1, I'm good. So, all right, 5, 4, 3, 2. And mind you, people, please, please make sure you cook your food thoroughly. Do not eat uncooked food. That is bad for your health. And do not serve people uncooked food either. Wow, look at that. You just gotta admire that. Like, literally, you gotta just look at that and admire it. Like, literally, look at that. Like, what is that? Like, seriously, what is that? Alright, so let's unplate these. There we go. Alright. Clean the grill. So we can put our nice and delicious next batch. And then I think we'll be done for the day. Putting all the stuff I'm taking off the grill onto the, the grease catcher. And mind you, all this is just cheese that's basically cooking on the grill, okay? All right, so we're gonna take our last ones. And as always, just slap it there, take the other one, slap it there, and then use our nice little secret. Don't tell nobody. Nice little secret to cook, which is Worcestershire sauce. You hear the sizzle? Alright. That's all you gotta do. Then close it up and let it do its thing. Then, as always, set your clock. As you said, like 6 minutes. 6 minutes. Can you see it right there? 6 minutes? People on Instagram, stop looking at my arm. Can you see the 6 minutes? I don't know if you can see the 6 minutes. There's 6 minutes on it. Oh, wait. It turned off. Sorry. There's the 6 minutes. I don't know if you can see it now. I think it's still turned off. I don't know. I can't really see the Instagram people's. I know they're probably mad. Hey, Joey, what up?
Who's coming on there? We got a few people over there.
This is why I need a social media person to be on this, so they can relay messages to me while I'm doing the cooking. Alright. And that's basically it. What else are we going to talk about? I mean, besides the fact that you guys wish you can be here and eat this. And I see Omar still... Damn. Are you serious? Yo, he ate one of them already. That is... Damn, it was that good? Was it cooked already, though? Okay. Whew. Shoot, I don't want to pay those hospital bills, man. Cool. So, is it juicy, flavorful? Like, what do you taste when you're eating it? Like, what do you taste like the most? Is it the sauce? Is it the cheese? Is it the ground beef? Because I can't see the other word because somebody over there is going to laugh. Listen, Omar just hungry, man. He just wants to eat. Oh, it's another one! Another D! We just broke another fork. So, seeing you guys don't know, this has been an ongoing tradition here, where that D started, actually, technically, that every time she went to sit down to eat a salad, she broke a fork. Every single time, without fail. So every time anyone breaks a fork in this place, they did a D. Now you know, shameless plug to D. I'm tagging you on this. But yes, that's how you know the food is that good. When you break a utensil, a plastic one though, not a metal one. You break a metal one, we gotta call somebody because that makes no sense on how you do that. Ooh, man, oh, you gotta smell this, people. You gotta smell this. Man, who else is on? No, wait, where's my regular peoples? Yo, what are you guys doing? Oh, wait, you're at work. That's why. Duh. But please, people, while you're watching this live, don't forget to watch Lunch Break, shameless plug, on your cable networks, which is Spectrum, RCN, and Verizon. Yes, shameless plug that I'm plugging in right now. And if you have no cable and you just have internet, you can watch it literally on my YouTube. Just look up Lunch Break Christian Knight and you will find me there. Or hit me up in any of the social media that are behind me. I'm everywhere. Instagram, Facebook, Pinterest, Twitter, Gmail, whatever. I had to look back because I don't know what I have. I have everything. But please, comment, like, send suggestions also. If you guys have an idea that you want me to make here for lunch break, please send it to me. I love suggestions. Even if you comment to say that you hate lunch break, I will welcome that too. But remember, don't say that until you try my food first. Ha! How about that one? Ha! Uh-oh, almost done. Oh, lunch break, good! There you go. Now someone's gonna have the ice in a few minutes. Oh man, that was great. This one's almost done, folks. And then, you know what we're gonna do? Is that we're gonna go off the air and we're gonna finish the rest of this to take home. Exactly. So, everybody at home, please remember, when you're making food, cook it thoroughly. Do not eat uncooked foods. It will mess you up and it's not healthy. So, as you're making the enchiladas, they, like I said, these were the bigger sized flour tortillas. So, when you're making your own enchiladas, make sure you get the small ones. And then just ground beef, turkey meat, chicken, even chicken you can make as enchiladas. Don't forget that. You can incorporate some green peppers into it if you want to. You can put scallion onions over it with some cheese and a little bit more sauce if you want after you cook it. As I said before, all you gotta really do is when you take the meat or the ground beef, you can season it however way you want, or if you want to use the way we season it here as a technique, it's just basically garlic powder, onion powder, black pepper, parsley flakes, one egg, and breadcrumbs. That's all you need for to season actual meat, whether it's ground beef, turkey meat, or chicken. Okay, chicken meat, because don't use regular chicken cutlet, or maybe you can. Hey, you know what, there is no wrong way of doing it, so you can add whatever meat type you want for your own enchiladas. Not necessarily has to do what we tell you, because hey, we're just doing something totally different as well. All right. Oh, hey, look, the clock just went off, right? All right, so let's get our dandy handy tongs. There we go. Oh my god, look at that. Remove this from here, place another plate. Place the last one on a plate two. And there you go, peoples. Bam. That was basically enchiladas. At lunch for your break. Or for your break at lunch. There you go. So people, it was nice seeing you guys, as always. It was nice chatting with you, as you guys were here with me, watching us do enchilada burritos. Because now I'm going to change it up from roll-ups to burritos, because that's what we made, that's how we made it. So, all those people at home, let's show you a nice little thing here. Thank you for enjoying our episode. I'm going to show it to Instagram first, because you know you want some. Thank you for enjoying another great episode of Lunch Break here. Look at that. Can you get in closer? Can you get in closer? Lunch Break episode here. Cooking for your lunch break. So as the saying goes, people. Anybody say? No? Okay. Don't settle for less and make it Lunch Break deliciousness. Your best. Goodbye, everybody. Thank you. Lunch break.
It started out like a totally normal day.
Mom!
Okay, move objection deadline to the third line after survey.
Oh, honey, for when you are, you always use the verb
best star.
What are you doing down there? Did you finish your breakfast?
Ow.
Don't hit your brother.
I mean, you have to eat something. Here.
Okay, 5 minutes to carpool. Where's my coffee?
You okay, Mom?
Oh, I'm fine. Sandwich orders. What do you want?
Almond butter and jelly.
Spaghetti.
Oh, you sure you're okay?
I'm fine, sweetie.
I am so late. Hey, buddy, how you doing? Hey, honey. You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
You sure?
Oh, yeah. Here.
Acai. My favorite. See you guys later.
Where are your shoes? Put your shoes back on, please. You know, go help your sister. We're going in 3 minutes. Oh, my God. What am I doing? I forgot to cut off the crust. Voila. Shoes on. Potty if you need it. Honey, get your sister. Okay, get her. Nobody move. I'm getting a dustpan.
Oh. Mom! I think you're having a heart attack.
Honey, do I look like the type of person who has a heart attack? I'm just gonna sit down.
Totally fine. Don't forget to wear the high socks with the shin guards.
Forget about the shin guards, Mom.
Come on, Mrs. Onderdonk is not gonna wait. Sorry to bother you. I think I might be having a little heart attack. Nothing really, just some nausea, tightening of the jaw, dizziness, shortness of breath, muscle pain, achiness, this terrible pressure in my chest. Oh, really? They can be here in how long? 2 minutes. Can you make it 10? I thought I had gas. Turns out, I was having a heart attack. Heart disease is the number one killer of American women. So now I take care of my heart, and I tell the women in my life to do the same.
Sounds great, by the way.
That's nice, sweetie, but that's not my heart. That is. Make it your mission to save your life and the lives of the women you love. Find out more from the American Heart Association at goredforwomen.org.
Scrawny, chubby, short,
queer.
Getting caught up in bullying, it's so easy, because you're just glad that you're not being bullied.
It's been hard for me to stand up for other people, because I feel like I'm already a target.
It's just easier to do nothing.
Stop.
Fine.
Dude, ow.
Fine.
Stop.
Fine.
Ow. Stop.
Do you have any friends?
Yes, I heard you.
What are you even doing here? It's almost too easy.
Ow. Stop.
Come on.
I get it.
Maybe
I
you
get
are
it.
A little bit more.
Oh.
You think you're special? One more Virginia meal.
I just opened it up and it's all smashed.
Did you order bullied or unbullied?
Bullied or unbullied?
Yeah.
Do you have a manager that I can speak to? Because that doesn't even make any sense.
Hi,
your manager.
Hi, how's it going?
I was given this.
Did you bully this burger?
Well, yeah. This is a defenseless Whopper Jr. It can't defend itself.
You don't mean anything by it.
It's just for laughs.
It's just for laughs.
Just give me my burger, man.
What the is going on here?
What? Are you, is there something wrong with you?
Because that's clearly what happened.
can't be serious.
Had you seen me bullying this burger, would you have stood up and said something?
Yeah.
It's good to know.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm okay.
Yeah? What's your name?
Reese.
Hi, Reese.
We're just having fun.
You having fun? He's not having fun. So therefore, I think you guys should just leave him alone.
Later. This feels better to me.
Have you ever been, like, messed with before?
Oh, my God. This is, like, the ideal world is where if somebody else sees, like, something weird happening, that they'll come over and be like, hey, this is not okay.
Yeah.
To feel defenseless, that's the one of the worst things in the world.
Chelsea came, and she would just tell them that it's not okay.
Because it isn't.
Something I'll never forget is my friend standing up for me.
I've been that kid, so if I see it, I'm gonna do something about it. And I hope there's more people out there like that.
Oh man, what's wrong, little butt?
Oh, I don't know, Big Booty. I just feel so little and lumpy. I want to be big and bootyful like you.
Oh, you are beautiful. You're just different. And being different is an asset. The world is full of all kinds of great butts. For example,
there are big butts, little butts, round butts, and flat butts. Buns of steel and squishy tushes, old buns and baby booty. Some butts are existential, some butts are influential. Bubble butts, chisel cheeks, and sassy sour freaks. These butts could break the internet with juicy booties dripping wet. They lit AF, the kids may say out of this world in the worst way.
Wow, so all butts are awesome.
Hell no! Have you seen cigarette butts? Look at this bullshit. These little are toxic.
So, I guess what we're saying is that all butts are better than cigarette butts.
He's now ready.
It's definitely a romantic comedy.
Wait beneath my wing.
No, you're drinking.
Shirt man. The heart attack sequel.
Falling down.
Ever happened to you? Harmless game of charades based on film titles turning into a sudden cardiac event? Bam! Shiklaki! No? What? Think you're better than me? Well, it happens, all right? It's a real life situation! I got my daughters here. Call 911. Push hard and fast, okay? Focus! And yes, the beat of staying alive really works. Shuma!
Disco can save lives. Yes, disco, huh? Check it out. What do you think? What? Dance Pate!
Patriotism. There's a word thrown around a lot. It inspires passionate debate, and it's worn like a badge of honor, and with good reason. Because it means love and devotion for one's country. Love. For a word designed to unite, it can also be pretty divisive. You see, there's more to patriotism than flag sequin with onesies and rodeos and quadruple cheeseburgers. Patriotism is love for a country. Not just pride in it. But what really makes up this country of ours? What is it we love? It's more than just a huge rock full of animals like cougars and eagles, right? It's the people. Do me a favor. Close your eyes for a second. I want to try something out. Picture the average U.S. citizen. Think about it. How old are they? What's their hair like? How much can they bench? You got one? Okay. So chances are, the person you're picturing right now looks a little different to the real average American. There are 319 million US citizens. 51% are female. So first off, the average American is a woman. Cool, huh? Is that what you pictured? 54 million are Latino, 40 million senior citizens, 27 million are disabled, 18 million are Asian. That's more people in the US than play football and baseball combined. 9 million are lesbian, gay, bi, transgender, more than the entire amount of people that live in the state of Virginia. Around 10 million are redhead, 5.1 million play ultimate frisbee, and 3.5 million are Muslim. Trip the number of people currently serving in the United States military. Almost half the country belongs to minority groups. People who are lesbian, African American, and bi, and transgender, and Native American, and proud of it. We know that labels don't devalue us, they help define us, keeping us dialed into our cultures and our beliefs and who we are as Americans. After all, what's more American than freedom to celebrate the things that make us, us? I mean, it's stitched into the stars and stripes of this country, from the Constitution to Gettysburg, to our motto, E Pluribus Unum, from many, one. It's even in our country's name, the United States. This year, patriotism shouldn't just be about pride of country. It should be about love, love beyond age, disability, sexuality, race, religion, and any other labels. Because the second any of us judge people based on those labels, we're not really being patriotic, are we? So let's try this one more time. Close your eyes. Picture the average Joe or Joan or Juan or Jean-Luc. The real people will make America, America. And this year, whenever you feel the urge to don those star-spangled shorts, set off fireworks the size of my biceps to show love for our country, remember that to love America is to love all Americans. Because love has no labels.